Hi everyone, just want to show you this electric DC motor hooked to a 5 1/4 drive low RPM motor. What I'm just showing here is how I can use one motor to turn an alternator and then step up a voltage from the source voltage being only 8 volts. So it's basically a mechanical inverter. Now I'm just going to turn it on and show you how it works. Well, you see on the meter, there's a choke voltage of 170 volts AC. Now I'm going to turn on the motor and then switch on a 7-watt incandescent bulb. Out of. Okay, so there's 7 watts and there's a voltage of 61 volts. And you can see when I switch off the load, then the RPM goes up. It's really out of balance now. Now I'm going to switch on the 13 watt fluorescent next. Power the motor up again and then try to attach the fluorescent light. Get it up to speed. Now the voltage is dropping off too low to power the light, so I'm only at 50 volts. Probably the transformer configuration is no good. Maybe if I found another transformer, it may power the light. Now I'm going to switch on a LED light. Okay, now I've hooked up an LED light. I've just pushed it between the prongs of the other night light. It's just an LED nightlight. And let's see how this works. So now it's powering over the voltage needed to run the light. So the LED is hardly any load. This thing's way out of balance because of the tape. But I'll show you how it... Even when you shut it off, the light keeps going and going. Now I'm just going to show you the frequency. I'll switch this over and I'll show you how many hertz this is at full RPM. It's getting out of balance again. I hate that when it happens. The tape's no good. Now what I've done here is I've just attached this 8-volt DC motor to this low RPM floppy drive motor. I've just taped it from this flywheel to this one, and it's just holding, so it's not very balanced, but this is just an experiment. And what I've done is I've wired it directly to the three wires coming out of the motor, so I bypassed all the electronics on this board, and I've just soldered in directly the wires going into the motor. You'd have to take this off and then trace the wires inside to figure that out. So I have here the 5 1/4 drive motor, and it's a low RPM motor. I have a few different ones. Here's another one. And I also have one that has been taken apart. Now there's the magnet. It has probably two poles, a north and a south, on it. And a that's just the cover with a bearing. Now here's the actual windings, the coils. So this is the type of setup you'd probably see in a low RPM alternator, like a wind generator or something. And there's also, you see wind generators, homemade ones, they have similar coil wiring, and but they use multiple magnets because it's a lot harder to find a magnet like that. Well, that was my demonstration of a electrical motor inverter or mechanical inverter. Thank you for watching.